This video is going to be about solving equations using addition or subtraction. So here's what we're talking about. Let's say you've got a problem like x plus 3 equals 7, and you want to find out what the x is. Well, that means we want to get the x all by itself. A way to get the x by itself would be to subtract this 3, get the 3 away from here. So I'm going to subtract 3 from this side of the equation. Now, whatever I do to one side of an equation, I have to do to the other side. So I'm going to subtract 3 from the other side of the equation. Carrying out the subtraction, I'm going to have an x plus 3 and negative 3. These will cancel, so I've got nothing left down here. And now I've got 7 minus 3, and that's going to be a 4. If I want to check these, I can go back to the original problem, x plus 3 equals 7. If I think that x equals 4, I'll replace the x with the 4. So 4 plus 3 equals 7, and 4 plus 3 does equal 7, so my solution is correct. Here's another one. This is going to be similar, but here we have x minus 4 equals, oh, let's say it equals negative 9. So I want to get rid of this negative 4. Well, a way to get rid of the negative 4 would be to add 4 to this side of the equation. If I add 4 to one side of the equation, I've got to add it to the other side of the equation. So seeing what this comes out to, I've got x over here, negative 4 and positive 4. Well, that's just 0, so I don't have to write that. Then I've got negative 9 plus 4. And this will give me a negative 5. Once again, I can check it. So I've got x minus 4 equals negative 9. Let's take that negative 5 and put it where the x is. So negative 5 minus 4 equals negative 9. And negative 5 minus 4 does equal negative 9. So this answer is right. Now, it doesn't matter which side your x ends up on. In other words, let's say we have 5 equals x plus 2. Remember, what you want to do is get the x by itself. That doesn't mean we have to get the x onto the left side of the equation. So the easiest way to get the x by itself over here would be to just get rid of the 2. So we'll get rid of the 2 by subtracting 2 from the right side of the equation. Once again, we've got to do the same thing to both sides. So I'm going to subtract 2 from the left side of the equation. Carrying out my subtraction, I get 5 minus 2 is 3. And that equals x and positive 2, negative 2. That's just going to be a 0. I don't have to write that. So x equals 3. I can rewrite this if I want to write my answer nicely as x equals 3. But in doing the arithmetic and doing the math, it doesn't matter where my x ends up. Let's check the answer. So I have 5 equals x plus 2, and I'm saying that x is the same as 3. So 5 equals 3 plus 2. 5 is the same as 3 plus 2. So this answer is correct. And that's all there is to it. Take care for now. I'll see you next time.